Assalamualaikum students. Our today's topic of discussion is phagocytosis. Students, it is a very frequently used terminology in microbiology. Let's continue with the discussion of phagocytosis. Phagocytosis, students. In very simple words, phagocytosis means to eat out. By definition, engulfment and destruction. Engulfment and destruction of solid particles by body cells is called phagocytosis. Okay, students? Engulfment and destruction of solid particles by the body cells is called phagocytosis. Now, students, these solid particles, these may be any foreign antigen which enters the host. For example, it may be bacteria, it may be fungus, it may be worms, or it may be any toxic substance or tissue debris, old worn out tissue parts, old worn out cells of the body. By body cells, which body cells? Body cells which are called phagosomes, phagocytes, sorry. Students, cells of our body which carry out the function of phagocytosis are called phagocytes. Now, what are different types of phagocytes in our body? Phagocytes. Students, there are three main types of phagocytic cells in our body. Number one, neutrophils. Number two, macrophages. And number three, monocytes. Okay, students, these are three main types of cells which perform the function of phagocytosis. And these three cells are neutrophils, macrophages, and number third, monocytes. Now, students, we move towards the details of phagocytic process. Students, the phagocytosis process is divided into seven stages. I repeat, the process of phagocytosis is divided into seven stages. Number one, margination. Margination. Students, in this phase, the phagocytic cells present in our blood, like neutrophils, monocytes, and macrophages, they line themselves along the walls of the blood vessels. And that wall of the blood vessel is called endothelium. So, margination is the process during which the phagocytic cells arrange themselves along the endothelium. Okay, students? Number second stage. Diapedesis. Diapedesis. Students, this stage is also called migration. Students, in this stage, the phagocytic cells, they leak out from the blood vessels and collect in the interstitial space or tissue spaces. Okay? Diapedesis, it is a process during which neutrophils, monocytes and macrophages, they leak out of the blood vessels and becomes arranged in the tissue spaces. Number third stage, chemotaxis. Chemotaxis. Students, in this stage, the phagocytic cells, they are attracted at the site of tissue damage. This chemotaxis, it is carried out by chemical substances which are called chemokines. And these chemokines, they are secreted by different tissue cells. Okay? These may be different chemokines like tumor necrosis factor. There is a vast variety of chemokines which attract the phagocytic cells at the site of injury. Interleukin 8, tumor necrosis factor alpha, these are different chemicals which attract the phagocytic cells at the site of injury, at the site of damage. Now students, number four stage of phagocytosis is opsonization. Opsonization. Students, opsonization means that any foreign antigen which enters the body of the host, it is made easier for destruction by the phagocytic cells. This process of opsonization, it is helped out by complement proteins like C3b. Okay, it helps in opsonization. Immunoglobulin G. Students, these proteins along with opsonins, these proteins, they attach themselves on the surface of foreign antigens. As a result, they become easier for destruction by phagocytic cells. Okay? Phagocytic cells, they contain receptors for these proteins. And these proteins present on the surface of foreign antigens, they become attached with the phagocytic cells, and so their destruction becomes easier. Now, number five step is engulfment. Engulfment. Students, once the foreign antigen becomes attached with the phagocytic cells, the phagocytic cells, they draw projections, cytoplasmic projections around the foreign antigen. As a result, they form a vacuole which is called phagosome. Phagosome. Student, what is phagosome? Phagosome is foreign antigen which is surrounded by the phagocytic cell cytoplasm. Okay? Now, after engulfment, the next step is degranulation. Degranulation. Students, once the phagocytic cells, they engulf the phagosome inside them, they release certain enzymes which are present inside the granules, and these granules are present in the cytoplasm of the phagocytic cells. Students, these enzymes, they include lysozymes, other myeloperoxidase enzymes, they are released from the granules of the phagocytic cells, and these enzymes, they help in the digestion of phagosome. Now, students, the next stage of phagocytosis is degradation. It is the last stage. Degradation. Students, degradation means killing of phagosome containing the foreign antigen. Students, this degradation, this killing of foreign antigen by the phagocytic cells, it is of two types, aerobic and anaerobic. This aerobic killing of foreign antigens by the phagocytic cells, it is oxygen dependent, and it is mainly carried out by oxygen derived free radicals. Oxygen derived free radicals like hydrogen peroxide, nitric oxide. These oxygen free radicals, they are helpful in aerobic killing of foreign antigens. Now, anaerobic killing. Students, this anaerobic killing It is oxygen independent. It does not require presence of oxygen for killing of the foreign antigen during phagocytosis. And this anaerobic killing, it is mainly carried out by hypochlorite ions. Hypochlorite ions. Next one, lactoferrins. Lactoferrins, lysozymes, these chemical products, hypochlorite ions, lactoferrins, lysozymes, they carry out anaerobic killing of antigen during the process of phagocytosis. Okay students, so these were the seven stages of phagocytosis, which involves killing of foreign antigen by phagocytic cells. Students, now at the end we discuss the clinical significance of phagocytosis. Students, the clinical significance include old worn out cells are removed from our body regularly by the process of phagocytosis. For example, old red blood cells. Their half-life is 120 days. After red blood cell completes her life of 120 days, they are removed from the blood circulation from the spleen by the process of phagocytosis. Number two, limiting of tissue damage. Students, as a result of tissue injury, inflammation starts in our body. And it is because of these phagocytic cells that inflammation is limited, localized at a particular site. Number third, control of infection. Student, any bacteria acting as foreign agent in our body, it is phagocytosed by our phagocytic cells like neutrophils, macrophages and monocytes. Okay students, so we can say that deficiency of phagocytic cells in any person leads to increased risk of infections. Increased risk of infection. Any person who develops deficiency of neutrophils, white blood cells, WBCs, he or she is at a greater risk of developing infections. So it was all about the process of phagocytosis. Thank you, students. Allah Hafiz.